¿Qué te pasa? ¿Estás llorando? Seguro es por desdenes de mujeres. Hey there, everyone. We are really happy to be here with you. Yes, we are there. Say hello to us. I can see some of you. And well, what can I say? Por favor, escríbanos. No olviden dar su pulgar arriba. No olviden darnos un like. También pueden escribir un comentario a quienes están. Un saludo. Y por favor, díganme si me pueden oír bien. Muchas gracias a todos los que nos acompañan semana a semana. Y bueno, mi nombre es Efraín.
Y yo soy Diego, chicos, bienvenidos nuevamente a una nueva emisión, por supuesto, de SpanishPod101.com. Hoy vamos a aprender, today we're going to learn something very interesting, and that's the demonstrative, adjectives, and pronouns. This is something that every beginner should know, every beginner, but you know, sometimes even intermediates struggle with this. So we're going to learn three different ways you can use demonstrative adjectives. Do you want to start reading some comments?
No, but you're better than this, on this
Okay,
than me.
okay. Perfecto. So, tenemos a Lía. Hola, Lía, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás?
Lía,
Qué gusto
muchas
verte.
gracias.
Jonathan Caballero.
Jonathan, ¿qué tal?
Perfecto, muchísimas gracias. Tenemos a Mausami Prapa.
Mausami.
Mucho gusto.
Mucho gusto.
No te habíamos visto, CM Lady.
CM Lady, claro.
Perfecto, muchísimas gracias. Tenemos a Ann. Tenemos a Ann.
Ah, ¿cómo estás?
Tenemos a JD Meyeres. Hola, hola
JD.
JD. Perfecto. Tenemos a Antonio, Antonio Reyes también.
Antonio Reyes, ¿cómo
Perfecto.
estás?
Tenemos a Mila, Mila.
Mila.
Muchísimas gracias por estar aquí. Tenemos a Il
Gracias.
Padrino, Il
El
Padrino.
padrino.
Hola, vatos, ¿qué tal? Hola, ¿qué tal?
Hola.
¿Pueden escuchar bien? Excelente. Tenemos a El
Sí.
Príncipe Río Riley. Como
Muy
siempre,
bien.
muchas gracias por estar con nosotros, Río.
Gracias, príncipe.
Lo apreciamos. Tenemos en Facebook a nuestra amiga Mayri Flores.
Mayri Flores, eres la onda.
Sí,
Gracias.
totalmente eres la onda. Gracias por estar
Gracias
ahí
por
siempre.
estar siempre.
Y pues bueno, ¿por qué no empezamos con esto, Efra? Tenemos some news for you.
Well, before that, or this news.
Not this news.
Ah, okay. Well, so you can get your free PDF cheat sheet in our site. SpanishPod101.com, where you can get your free lifetime account. Lifetime account, okay?
Perfecto.
So increase your vocabulary set, discover new phrases. We have PDF cheat sheets about everything. Everything. Time, relationships, emergency phrases, social media,
Travel,
religion,
and work.
travel, love. Everything,
Exactly.
everything, and it is for free. So get now your free lifetime account. Get now, it is in the description, and it is up there on Facebook. Get it now, and our PDF cheat sheet of how to get a husband is soon will be there.
Soon we'll be there.
And make sure to,
Yeah.
you know,
No, we said that we're going to make a video, so
make
we're
a
going to create
video.
it, so stay updated. So, también tenemos aquí a Hitman Hill. Hola, buenas noches, muy buenas noches. Busnaps,
Hitman,
hola.
Busna.
Beerfliegen durch die Zeit, hola, hola. Tenemos a Cristina CB.
Cristina.
Cristina, pero bien, muy bien, súper, súper bien.
Muy bien.
Excelente, pues bueno, vamos
Saludos.
a ver esto, chicos. Let's get started with this. Y
Saludos.
vamos a ver primero esto. ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre este, estos, esta y
Sí,
estas?
claro.
¿Cuál es la diferencia? What's the difference between these? So, which adjective you use depends on two things. Estos son adjetivos, adjetivos demostrativos, ¿ok? So, which adjective you use depends on two things. Number one, how many objects there are. That is the number, and how close they are to you. How
Okay.
close? Is it like here, here, like over there?
Ajá.
Okay? So these two things take into account. The next one. Now let's start with demonstrative adjectives that you use when something is near. Near.
Okay.
So for this, we have four. And this depends, as I said, on number and also gender. So if it is something singular and masculine, such as, for example, collar.
Collar.
Collar, exactly, a necklace. Okay, un collar. Mm. Es masculino. Este collar. Este collar.
Este collar.
Este collar es de oro. Este collar es de oro.
¡Ah, perro! ¡Ah, perro! ¡Ah, perro! A ver, saca el de plata.
Ah, también tengo uno de plata. También tengo uno de plata. Entonces,
estos collares son de plata. Estos
collares son de plata. ¿Ese es de plata?
Sí, es de plata.
Pensé que era de acero.
Ah, no, no. ¿Qué pasó?
¿Es de plata?
Es de plata. Ah, este collar es de plata.
Ok. Estos collares son de plata. Because they are near, right? Pero también tenemos esta, ¿ok? Esta, when something is singular and feminine, ajá, such as playera.
¿Esta playera?
Esta playera me gusta mucho.
Ok.
Esta playera me gusta mucho. And if it is plural feminine, estas.
Estas playeras no tienen estampados, no tienen dibujos. Bueno, sí. No. Bueno, solo tiene uno. Chiquito. Man, a ti parece que te patrocina Nike.
Y Bench.
Siempre, o sea.
Oh, es para mí, es mi sueño.
Yo le doy variedad, yo compro marcas mexicanas.
Es mi sueño que Bench me patrocine, sí, y que diga, oye, ese chico le gusta nuestra ropa, vamos a patrocinarlo, pero.
Quizá algún día, no es hoy, no será mañana, pero quizá algún día.
Es un sueño guajiro. So, let's continue. So far, let's continue with some examples.
Quiero comprarme este vestido. Uh-huh. Quiero comprarme este vestido. Move. Okay. Este vestido. I want to buy this dress. Esta canción es muy pegajosa. Esta canción es muy pegajosa. This song is very catchy.
Okay.
An example of a catchy song. Una pegajosa.
Give me one. Acereje. Well, that's very acereje. Old. That's super old. But a recent one.
Argentina, esa es una canción argentina. Se te nota que quiero.
Vale. Okay, the next one.
Estos son mis libros favoritos. Estos son mis libros favoritos. These are my favorite books.
Bien.
Obviously, Lovecraft is my favorite one. Horror.
Author?
Horror. Yeah.
Okay. Writer.
¿De qué están hechas estas playeras? Man, I wasn't very creative when I wrote
that. ¿De qué están hechas estas playeras? Bueno, la mía está hecha de seda, de la seda más fina.
Bien. ¿De qué están hechas estas playeras? What are these shirts made of?
Very good. So you have estos libros, estas playeras. Very good.
Yeah.
Now let's continue with ese, esos, esa, and esas. Mm-hmm. Now this is going to be slightly different. So take some notes here, guys. Uh-huh. Tomen algunas notas. Ese is used to point out nouns that are further from mm-hmm. the speaker and not easily within yeah. reach. So I cannot reach them easily. So that's the thing.
You can see them.
You can see them though. The noun may be close to the listener but not the speaker. So this is also a clue. The noun may be close to the listener, but not the speaker. Okay? So, uh-huh.
so
the
yeah.
demonstrative adjective are ese, esa, esos, mm-hmm. and esas, which is basically yep. ese and esa, that, and esos and esas, those.
Yeah.
Okay? So, which agree in gender and number, of course, such as este, esta, estos, y estas.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's see here the table as well. If it is singular and masculine.
Ese.
Okay? Now, this is very important, guys, because this is not always for objects.
Mm-hmm.
It could be also for people. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's not only for objects. It's whatever noun. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, for example, ese chico es muy buena onda. There's no one there, but it's just like...
Not again!
Oye, esa niña no tiene cabeza.
Oye, esa niña no la conozco.
Oye, ¿quién es esa niña?
¿Quién es?
No, don't say that, because there is indeed a ghost here in my house, so no. Okay, so ese...
Not again.
That's for singular, okay? Then we have esos, plural.
Ajá.
Plural, okay? Esos. For example...
So, when you're in a store... The speaker, the thing is, the noun is not near
close
to the
speaker, close to the listener. I am the listener.
Me puede mostrar, can you show me puede mostrar ese perfume, no, esa...
Esos.
Oh, ay, perdón, ese, esos.
Esos.
Ok. Esos perfumes.
Ya, o esos tenis.
Esa, ¿me puede mostrar esa pulsera?
Ya, yeah, sure.
Ese brazalete.
Ya, yeah, sure.
Esas, ¿qué sería?
Playeras.
Playeras, uh-huh. Esas calcetas.
Esas calcetas, when you're in a store, very good, very good. Esas, sí. Ok, perfecto.
Es, o sea, es muy útil cuando estás ahí. Bien, ¿me puedes pasar ese libro que está detrás de ti? ¿Me puedes pasar ese libro que está detrás de ti? Can you pass me that book behind you, or can you hand me?
Sí, mm-hmm. Perfecto, muy bien. Okay. Muy bien. Perfecto.
Sí, perfecto.
Ok. Yeah. It's like, dale el avión.
Bien, esos adornos siempre me han gustado mucho. Esos adornos siempre me han gustado mucho. I have always liked those ornaments very much, or that decoration. That's why it's not Halloween anymore.
It's okay. Yeah.
I'm stuck.
These are not anymore, like this decoration is of Dia de Muertos, but...
And Halloween, but yeah.
Soon we will change it for Christmas, soon. Okay, soon. Very good. Or?
Bien, esa guitarra está padrísima. Esa guitarra está padrísima.
What is padrísima, by
the
way?
So, padrísima comes from padre, mm-hmm. which is Mexican slang to say cool.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Padre, cool. Padrísima, super cool.
Or amazing.
Or amazing.
Yeah, good.
Okay. Padrísima. That guitar is amazing. Esa guitarra está padrísima. ¿Cuánto cuestan esas flores? ¿Cuánto cuestan esas flores? How much do those flowers cost?
Muy bien, okay. Very good. Now, vámonos con some notes here. So, let's see some examples. Me encanta esa playera. Look at this. Me encanta esa playera.
Yeah,
I love that shirt. Or,
me encanta esa playera.
Qué hermoso está ese, mm-hmm. ese reloj yeah. de pared. How beautiful that wall clock is.
Yeah. Okay?
Este es mi dinero.
Este es mi dinero.
¿Ok?
5 pesitos.
Not, that's it. I have more, but not we place este, esta, ese, esa, estos, mm-hmm. estas, and esos, esas,
yeah.
in front of the nouns they modify. Or in other words, they come, you know, before. Okay?
Okay.
Before.
Mm-hmm.
Before or in front.
In okay. front of the nouns, they modify.
Such as,
este.
Comes before dinero.
Uh-huh.
Ese comes before reloj. Esa comes before playera.
Yeah.
Very good. Demonstrative adjectives for singular items are este and ese.
Este and ese.
Be careful, because uh-huh. sometimes you hear esto and eso.
Sí.
But we're going to talk about this later, slightly
so,
later, okay?
So, yeah. Don't rush.
Hold on with us. So, however, first we just want to remind you that we have for you mm-hmm. your free PDF cheat sheet
yes.
that you can get, obviously for free.
Yes.
$0.
No.
And all you have to do is click on the link down below, or if you're on Facebook, right here next to Efrain's face, you will find the link.
Yeah.
Please do it, guys, and learn lots and lots of vocabulary with our amazing sí. PDF cheat sheets. They are padrísimas. Padrísimas.
Están padrísimas.
Están padrísimas. So, why don't we read some comments?
Sí, claro.
Claro. Perfectísimo.
Macarena.
¡Ay! ¿Cómo se llaman? ¡Ey, Macarena!
¡Ay!
Jennifer Hunt.
Calma tu cuerpo,
pan. Tenemos a Jennifer Hunt. Tenemos a Cody. Hola,
Jennifer.
Cody. Bienvenido, Cody. Y el padrino.
El padrino.
Ok. Rimpuli. Learn from India.
Rimpuli.
Bienvenido.
Saludos.
Tenemos también. Estos enseñantes están padrísimos. We are padrísimos.
Son padrísimos.
Very good.
Qué
perfecto.
Detalle. Gracias, Lía.
Vamos a ver en Facebook si tenemos a alguien. Tenemos, por supuesto, a Trudy. Tenemos a Trudy. Muchísimas gracias por estar con nosotros, Trudy.
Por favor, a nuestros amigos en Facebook, no se les olvide compartir este video.
Y darle su me encorazona.
Yeah, please share this video.
Me encorazona.
We want to reach more learners. And don't forget to give us your thumbs up. Or
if you're already here in YouTube, please give us your thumbs up.
Or your heart in Facebook, because
or comment, just comment or something.
Comment, yeah.
Let us know that you are watching us, guys.
Sí, 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 por favor.
We love to see that. Okay. Now, vamos a ver qué pasa con aquel, aquellos, yeah. aquella y aquellas.
Aquel, aquellos, aquel.
Aquel, aquellos, aquella y aquellas.
Aquella y aquellas. Uh-huh.
So, aquel basically is used to talk about nouns that are far away. Far away from both the speaker and the listener.
Usually.
Usually. Now, in other words, for you to remember, este, ese, aquel.
Yeah.
Is not within reach. Okay? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
These demonstrative adjectives are translated as that over there, okay, mm-hmm. and those over there, basically. Yeah. Keep in mind that they all refer to a further distance from the speaker and the listener as well.
Yeah.
Let's see this table. Remember, singular and masculine is going to be for aquel.
Aquel.
For example, ¿te acuerdas de aquel lugar?
Aquel lugar, sí.
Aquel lugar. So, plural for aquellos. Masculine, aquellos. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Aquellos.
Aquellos muchachos, aquellos chicos. Wow. Eran muy amables. Aquellos chicos eran muy amables.
Very good.
No? So, but we are not seeing them anymore.
We don't see them and they are not within reach. Mm-hmm. And they are far away. So it's aquellos.
We don't know where they are. Uh-huh.
Singular feminine, aquella.
Aquella.
Aquella montaña tiene nieve uh-huh. en la cima.
¿Ya? Yeah.
Aquella montaña tiene yeah. nieve en la cima.
Aquellas, now aquellas for plural and feminine nouns. Uh-huh.
Plural feminine.
Plural feminine. Uh-huh. Yeah, whatever.
That's okay. Aquellas.
Aquellas, aquellas cosas que me decías.
Aquellas cosas, ya no te creo.
Aquellas cosas
que decías eran puras mentiras.
Those things that you used to tell me were yeah. lies. Aquellas lies. Cosas que me decías.
Or, we have more examples for you guys.
¿Aún no recuerdas aquel día en que intentamos hacer un video de terror? ¿Aún recuerdas aquel día en que intentamos hacer un video de terror?
Yeah.
Do you still remember that day when we tried to make a horror video?
Okay, so very quick story time here, guys. Yes, we started to create some horror clips.
Yeah.
That was the first intention when we created a YouTube channel.
That was our first video in YouTube.
That was our first video. Of uh-huh. course, it was horrible. So we said, no, let's make another thing. And that's how we started recording
videos.
We are
here.
Uh-huh. So,
like 5 years ago, I guess. Or
yeah, it was so much ago. So much time ago.
6 años, creo.
Aquella vez tuve mucha suerte.
Aquella vez tuve mucha suerte.
That time I was very lucky.
Uh-huh.
Aquella vez.
So you can also use aquel, aquellos, aquella, and aquellas for concepts, abstract concepts.
Mm-hmm.
Like aquella vez, aquellas cosas que me decías.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
So that's also for abstract and not within reach things. Uh-huh. Like recuerdos, right? It's not something that you can
memories.
See and mm-hmm. it's not within reach. So aquellos recuerdos son maravillosos. Aquellos días, aquellas uh-huh. mañanas, you see?
Sí, sí,
like
sí.
All these concepts.
Uh-huh. Or, toma uno de aquellos platos que están en la mesa.
Very good.
Toma uno de aquellos platos que están en la mesa. Take one of those plates that are on the table.
Very good.
Ajá. Uh-huh. Aquellas chicas son mis primas. Aquellas chicas son mis primas. Those girls are my cousins.
Very
aquellas
good.
Chicas son mis primas.
Muy bien, mm-hmm. muy bien. Vamos ahora a ver este tema. So, take out your pencil, your pen, and take note of this. Because this is very important as well.
Uh-huh.
Because we have aquello, eso, and sí. esto. How do we use it? ¿Cómo usamos? ¿Cómo lo usamos? Even though esto, eso, and aquello might seem normal uh-huh. demonstrative adjective pronouns,
uh-huh.
note. They are not, okay?
What do you mean?
Well, they have a different function from este, ese, and aquel, and actually pronouns, these are pronouns, okay? Esto, eso, and aquello are considered neuter,
okay.
neuter, without gender. without gender.
That's interesting.
For example,
estamos perdidos.
Perdidos. Ay, ayúdenos, estamos perdidos.
Ok, let's continue.
Estamos perdidos y mi teléfono no funciona. Esto no puede ser bueno. Estamos perdidos y mi teléfono no funciona. Esto no puede ser bueno.
We are lost and my phone does not work. This cannot be good.
Very good.
This
now,
can't be good.
Esto basically involves a situation. Okay? Esto involves a situation, but instead of saying esta situación, you can just say esto. Right?
Esto.
Esto no puede ser bueno. Very good. Now,
no le creas cuando te dice que se le acabó la pila de su celular.
Okay.
Eso es un engaño. No le creas cuando te dice que se le acabó la pila de su celular. Eso es un engaño.
Bien.
Don't believe him when he tells you that his cell phone battery ran out. That is a lie.
That's your excuse number one. Like, oh, ¿por qué no me contestaste? Ay, perdón, es que mi pila se me acabó.
Perdóname, muchacha.
Perdón. Okay, very good. In this case, eso es un engaño.
Eso,
that's a lie, no? So, can we say ese es un engaño?
Yeah, maybe, but that sounds weird.
No, it doesn't sound like ese es un engaño.
Ese es un engaño.
Ese es un engaño, yeah, or eso es un engaño. So, sometimes, and hopefully I won't confuse you guys, but sometimes, and it depends on the situation, you can change eso and ese, okay? You can change it. You can, eso, remember that it's neuter. And it involves like an abstract concept or involves a full situation. That's where you can use eso. And ese is also is rather when you use it with a noun. In this case, engaño, that's a noun, so ese es un engaño.
Ese es un engaño.
Very good. Or,
okay, ya no te metas en sus problemas de pareja. Aquello es un embrollo.
Very good.
Ya no te metas en sus problemas de pareja. Aquello es un embrollo. Don't get into their relationship problems anymore. That is a mess.
Very good.
That is okay. So, yeah.
Very good. Perfect. So, excellent, guys. We use esto, eso, and aquello when we aren't worried about gender. So, remember, we are not worried about the gender, and it involves also a full situation. That's where we use esto, eso, and aquello. Very good, guys. So, we don't care about number since we're talking about a singular concept. Okay, not plural objects.
No.
So this is clue about a concept, not plural objects.
Yeah.
Very good.
Okay.
Let's start with the summary and the quiz.
Esas son puras mentiras.
Esa noche yo no andaba ahí.
I'm sorry. I'm like.
Let's remember that we have four demonstrative adjectives, and it depends on two things. First of all, if it is within reach or not. And second, on gender and also number.
Yeah.
For that, we have este and estos, that for masculine. Este singular, estos plural. Esta, feminine singular. Estas, feminine plural.
Near.
And that's something near. If something is slightly far, we will say ese. However, within reach. Ese, esos, for plural. Ese singular, esos plural. Esa, feminine singular. Esas, feminine plural. Also, remember that these are used before a noun.
Yeah.
Okay? Este cuarto, esta casa, ese dinero, esa chica.
Something far.
Very good.
Or close to the listener.
Close to the listener as well. Aquellas is far from the listener and also the speaker.
Yeah.
And aquel is masculine singular, aquellos masculine plural. Then we have aquella feminine singular, and then aquellas feminine plural. And that's
this over there. That,
over there.
That over there.
And this is not within reach.
Those over there. These. Oh, no, this not.
Those over there.
I didn't. That over there and those over there.
Those over there.
Forgive me, because I said this. But
that over there. That over there. Then we have aquello es honesto. These are pronouns. These are pronouns, and these are used whenever we don't care about the gender.
For abstract
situations. And abstract situations.
Or concepts.
Very good. Very good. Excellent, guys. Excellent. So now, this is your turn, guys. Let's start with this. Translate these sentences to Spanish. Number one.
That book is mine, but that one over there is hers.
If you have watched our previous episodes, you should know how to say mine and hers.
Yeah.
So, exactly. We will start. Vamos a esperar.
Vamos a ver algunos comentarios mientras tanto.
¿Qué tenemos? So, Neko means cat in Japanese. Okay, today I learned that Neko means, and now I know why it's called Neko Punch. Neko?
Oh.
Neko is cat.
Very interesting. I didn't know.
Jennifer Hunt,
Cody.
Estos celos me hacen daño.
Me enloquecen. Jamás podría. Okay, let's go.
I didn't know that one. Okay, it's very useful. Very useful.
That one.
Very good.
We want to see the horror video. I'm going to show it to you.
Personally, Leah. Yeah. Because it is not about horror. It's so pathetic.
Yeah.
So basically, pathetic.
Basically.
Okay, so what else? No sé qué hago aquí. Ya hablo español. Well, you are here for having a fun time. Tony Station.
Yeah.
Okay. Rio Riley, was the video too scary for the public? No, it was actually very awkward for the public. So that's...
It
was not good.
No, it was fun to record. Lame.
It was really fun to record. Uh-huh. Okay, very good. So vamos a ver. So we already have... Debes estar confundida o había un tipo igualito a mí. Yeah, era mi gemelo.
No, for the song.
I know, pero era mi gemelo, no era yo. So whenever you want to avoid a situation, you just say, oh, perdón, es que era mi gemelo.
Esas
es que
son no sabías. Mentiras.
Tengo un gemelo, es mi gemelo maligno.
Esa no te lo
So, mejor. Very good, Leah, let's see. Este no libro es mío, pero aquel es suya. Ese libro es mío, pero aquel es suyo.
Uh-huh.
Okay, suyo. That's correct, very good, guys.
Ese
libro es mío, pero aquel es de ella, or suyo.
Es suyo.
As well, suyo works as well.
Ajá.
Okay. Sí, remember that you can use suyo, o de él, o de ella. Remember this. Very good. The second one.
This table is mine, but that one is hers. Yeah, it doesn't make sense. I'm sorry. But...
You were too creative here.
Yeah, right? This table is mine. I was like...
This table is mine,
this table.
But that one is hers.
Yeah, like...
You even use you're... the same one, but that one is hers.
No watches, I didn't know, sorry.
But this one is this, and then it's table. That one.
This
that
table.
One. Okay.
It's because, what if you're in a quinceañera, and you're like...
In a quinceañera party?
Yeah, you have your table,
and
man.
Like, hey, esta... Ah.
Esta es mi mesa.
Es... Exactly, so let's see.
Por eso esperaba con la carita.
Here we have a quote. This is my rifle. There are a lot like it, but this is my rifle. Is that from a movie? I don't get the reference.
This is my rifle.
I don't get it. Do you get the reference? Let's see on Facebook.
So, esta mesa es mía.
Mary Flores dice, esta mesa es mía, pero esa es de ella.
Sí.
Very good. Okay.
Muy bien.
Muy bien. So, let's see.
Aquella no es mía.
Esta mesa es mía, pero esa es de ella. You got it 100% correct, Mary
Flores. I'm sorry, I wasn't very creative today.
Very good. Rio Riley, esta mesa es mía, pero aquella es de ella.
Go and hide it now.
I go hide now.
Escóndela.
I go hide now. I don't know. Is that a movie? I don't know. I don't truly know.
No, I don't know.
The third one, this is absurd. Is it absurd or absurd? Absurd, right? Absurd. How does that sound better? Absurd or absurd? I will say absurd. This is absurd. How would you say? This is absurd or absurd? I don't know.
I don't want to say.
Well. This word actually is absurdo. It's very close to Spanish. Absurdo.
For example, Marie Rachel, why not suya?
Which one? Oh, de ella. You can use suya.
You can use
it's
suya.
A synonym.
Uh-huh.
It's a synonym.
I just wanted to say de ella to specify that it was hers. Mm-hmm.
Esto es absurdo. That's correct. Very good, guys. Perfecto. Esto es absurdo.
Esto es absurdo.
We have the last one for you, guys. The last one is...
Those mountains...
Mountains.
Mountains are taller than those ones. Medium distance and long distance.
Those mountains in the medium distance that are like kind of not that far are taller than those ones, which mm-hmm. is like a long distance. Okay, so how would you say this? So Mary Rachel, esta mesa es mío. No, actually, esta mesa es mía.
Because you're talking about the...
You need to match with the gender.
Uh-huh.
Pero aquella, once again, match with the gender, es de ella. Or es suya.
Es suya.
Mm-hmm. Very good, very good.
Yeah.
Facebook. So, let's see in Facebook. Esto es absurdo. Este es absurdo. Be careful, Trudy, with this. Este es absurdo, because this is... Esto, like a concept, like a situation, mm-hmm. that's why it is esto.
Esto
es absurdo. Very good, very good.
And esto is a pronoun, mm-hmm. it's not a demonstrative.
Rio O'Reilly says, no, but an avid movie watcher. I want to know why, I want to know. Why? Leah, are you a Marine? Oh mm-hmm. my god, they are talking in, like, están hablando en clave.
I don't get it, man.
I don't get it either.
I prefer to sing, just sing.
I don't know, but okay, esas montañas son más altas que aquellas, esas montañas son más altas que aquellas, esas montañas son más altas que aquellas, esas montañas son más altas que aquellas.
Muy bien.
Yeah, very good.
Muy bien.
Very good.
Muy bien. Bien, mi padrino.
Esas montañas bien. Son más altas que aquellas. You got it. Guys, you are so intelligent. You are so
Esas montañas son más altas.
Very ¿Qué? Good.
Mary Flores solamente cambia de porque
uh-huh. son más altas que
son más altas.
Actually, que... we use comparatives in the previous lesson.
Uh-huh.
So if you want to recheck that lesson, go and do it now. It is that you will learn why is que.
Uh-huh.
Pretty good. Very good. Oh well, we have a bonus one.
I like these rings. Said Gollum.
Oh really? I like these rings.
No, it's like Gollum.
Like the
Gollum.
Yeah, the rings.
Because he likes
it's a short wrist. This ring, by the way, is anillo. Very good.
Do you know a song with anillo?
Yeah.
A ver.
Let me think 1 second. Anillo.
Ese par de anillos.
Yeah. No, you're
sí, in, no. It is real.
Okay, I have one for you. No one gets this. Nopal. Nopal. No one knows this. I'm the only one who knows that.
Gringo.
A song?
Yeah, with a song.
Gringo?
Sí.
Is that includes nopal? The word nopal? Let me tell you.
A ver.
Que vuelve a quien lo toma. Gavila nopal. No.
Sí, es cierto. Que no manches.
Okay. Me gustan estos anillos.
Ah, Saturno.
Con los Saturnos. Me gustan estos anillos.
Me gustan estos anillos. Very
good, muy guys. Bien. Perfecto, pues.
Contaré la historia.
Me gustan estos anillos. Very good, very good.
Todos
so,
la conocen
con el apodo de Chola. Que va, diario va a los bailes y se compra una botella. O sea, es riquísima la Chona. So, exclamations in Spanish. The next lesson is going to be about exclamations in Spanish. So thanks today, guys, for being here with us. We reached 49 viewers. So
uh-huh.
to all our 49 viewers, thanks a lot. Don't forget to watch our newest video here in Spanish Pod 101 when you are going to learn the different sounds of the X.
In Spanish.
Yeah, of course. In Spanish.
Of the X in Spanish.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. So go and watch it now. Before, please give us your thumbs up,
mm-hmm.
share this video, please, guys, and here on Facebook, please share this video and help us there.
Okay.
And
I have the explanation of...
You have it.
My rifle is a poem that Marines have to memorize during their basic training. It was made famous in a movie by Stanley Kubrick called Full Metal Jacket. Oh, wow.
I watched it.
Thanks for that explanation.
Yo la vi, pero no me acuerdo.
Muchísimas gracias, muchísimas gracias.
No me acuerdo.
Toma. ¿Cuál
es? Si no me acuerdo.
No pasó.
Es que no pasa.
Muchísimas gracias, chicos. Nos vemos. Les mandamos un enorme, enorme abrazo.
Un abrazo. Exclamation in Spanish. ¡Qué bueno!
Next. Exactly. ¡Qué bueno!
¡Qué onda!
You're going to learn how to make exclamations in Spanish.
What a
wonderful. Don't spoil the lesson. You're going to learn how to make exclamations in Spanish.
Yeah.
See you there, guys.
Why we don't use articles there? Okay. November. Next week. November the 19th, and yeah.
Same guys, same time.
Same time.
See you there, guys.
Half an hour before.